Touch him up. If you're going to touch him up, let's go.
So we are set five-minute rounds for the ATOMWEIGHT CHAMPIONSHIP. Tiburcio. And the champion, Michelle Waterson. The bell and round one. Tiburcio in the red and gray, the champion Waterson in the blue. Immediately, Tiburcio coming forward with strikes. What do you look for early in this one, Julie?
Speed. One of Michelle Waterson's biggest strengths is her speed and her precision punching. Tiburcio has a lot of speed going for her as well. I'm gonna be interested to see who can maintain that with power. Speed, power, movement, speed, power, movement. That's really what's gonna win this fight.
Well, it looks like they both started off with a lot of speed and a lot of movement. And the power looks like it's coming on even more as they're going.
Waterson was a karate kid, starting the martial art at the age of 10. She says that right now, the most that she uses from her karate background would be her kicks, but they aren't necessarily karate kicks, but the quickness of the kicks is what sets her apart from a lot of other MMA fighters out there. She can shoot kicks quicker, and she can put power behind it as Tiburcio, though, takes her down.
And Michelle is very, very good at getting arm bars off of her back. She's got a couple flying arm bar wins, actually, to her credit. You can see that she attempted that right there, and Tiburcio is now pushing down on her and trying to get the leverage to keep her from doing that.
Tiburcio says the key is never to surrender. The key is her heart. She doesn't care who her opponent is. And she is, again, in her first fight at 105, her first fight at Invicta FC, is now challenging for the championship.
Well, and the way that they're doing it up against the cage, too, the cage can either be your best friend or...
Yeah, and you're Waterson looking for that. Oh, and there's Tiburcio. Waterson continuing to hold on to the arm. Belly down, Russian-style armbar attempt, but now Tiburcio back wide base and just delivering those jackhammer rights to the face of Waterson.
Tiburcio needs to not be wearing that half shirt. Leslie and I were speaking about that earlier. It's actually kind of dangerous. You need to be wearing something a little bit more skin tight. I feel like her limbs or Michelle's limbs could get stuck in there like fingers and toes.
Mm-hmm. That's why we usually wear tight clothes for fighting. It's not because it looks great on TV. It's because
it's safety. Uh-huh. I hope that they rectify that in between rounds. It looks like she's locking her head down trying to get that guillotine. It looks like her arm is quite deep. I can't quite see the angle there. Oh,
wants to change levels, but Waterson with the overhook. Pummeling on the fence there and just controlling Tiburcio's wrist. Waterson wants to get away from the cage.
Man, we finally saw a foot stomp. The crowd has been yelling for a foot stomp all night long.
Oh, into the streets.
Texas loves foot stomping.
Wow, powerful kick.
Whipping kicks, but Tiburcio showing no real respect for the champion, but there's a beautiful. And now Waterson in full mount. A minute and a half left in a frenetic first round.
And that was a beautiful takedown straight to mount.
Left hand to the side of Tiburcio's face.
And we've seen Tiburcio in this position before, again, when she fought Gadella, and Gadella actually fights at 115 pounds now. And that's the weight class that they fought in. So I don't think Tiburcio, she's in danger here, but I don't think she's gonna be panicky here just yet.
Final minute of the opening round. The champion, Michelle Waterson, in dominant position. Beautiful sweep by Tiburcio. But now Waterson again looking to snatch the arm. Tiburcio shoots the right hand down at Waterson's face. So back and forth we go, and you guys are right about that top. But look at how aggressive Michelle Waterson is from the bottom again, looking for the belly down arm bar. 30 seconds remaining. A whirling dervish of activity.
Look at the way Tiburcio is putting her foot in Michelle's face like that to get leverage. It's very, very crafty. It's very unpleasant to have somebody's toes in your mouth.
Being the heel in more ways than one there with 15 seconds left in the opening frame. And again, Waterson does not want to let that arm go.
Whoa.
Relentless.
That is flexibility.
Wow, flexibility. Great opening round here.
Yeah, that's flexibility that you see a lot from women that you just don't get. That's one of the reasons I like training with women sometimes, is because training with men, it's not quite the same.
Oh, there's a giant hematoma under Michelle's eye right now. The action in this fight. You can see Tiburcio picking her, taking some damage right there, grabbing onto that foot and just pushing forward, trying to get that trip. Pushing Michelle right onto her back like that. You know, in the scramble, Michelle's looking for those arm bars. She's got such sneaky arm bars that can come from any angle. And then let's go, and Michelle just gets a takedown of her own, reaching around the head and tossing right over. Advancing into the mount beautifully. Very, very smoothly done.
Now, not to belabor the point, my friends, but Tiburcio continues to wear that top, which, as you astutely mentioned, Julie, is a danger to both of these athletes, and yet the commission has not made her take it off.
I feel, of all commission things that could be sticking points, that top should come off.
Yeah, it's interesting that they had made Peggy Morgan cut off the bottom of her pants.
Oh, wow.
Quick start by Michelle Waterson here in round two, but already showing the effects of swollen left eye. And Tiburcio again goes on the attack. Just very aggressive. Both of these fighters knowing what is at stake. The Atomweight Championship, and Tiburcio acquitting himself well thus far.
Yeah, she's doing very, very well on that. You know, Michelle's face is the one that's showing damage right now. Look at the way Tiburcio is pushing her up against the cage. One of the things you notice about Tiburcio is that she's got just such thick, strong legs that she can really generate a lot of power from. You can really push on somebody. And she's just pushing her on the cage, grinding her on the cage like that. It's very exhausting.
Battling for the takedown. Maura Ranallo along with Julie Ketzi and Leslie Smith joining us here.
Oh,
this main event is a scramble, and Waterson ends up on top.
Beautiful way to get out of that. She was on her back. Michelle
She's
was
very creative.
Diving through that arm bar, excuse me. It was a very, very good way to combat that.
And it looked very cool too. It looks like after getting that reversal earlier that she's really focusing on staying on top, on keeping her control.
And look at the way she's attempting to control Michelle's left wrist to stop her from getting those hard punches off. I think that actually Tiburcio is going to try and kind of teeter-totter, sweep her over with her legs and disrupt her balance. But Michelle's got very, very good balance.
2 minutes gone in the second. Tiburcio aggressive from the bottom. Waterson equally aggressive on top. Tiburcio looking for that heel hook. Now the toe hold.
Yeah, I don't think she's in a position to actually finish that right there, especially against somebody so flexible.
Oh, hammer fist from Waterson at the top, and those have allowed her to get out of the position, extricating herself from Tiburcio's grip, Leslie.
Yes. And then they're back at it, going for it in the stand-up again. Man, these are very, very exciting fighters, both of them to watch. They're striking, they've got these takedowns.
And the conditioning should not be a problem, especially the champion we've seen over and over. She can go 25 minutes and probably another 25, right, Julie?
Yeah, she's always prided herself on the high conditioning. You know, she trains at high altitudes. She was born and raised in Colorado in high altitude. Wow, she's been taking some hard knees.
But now north-south position.
she just put herself in a pretty bad position there.
Do you think she was trying to go for a flying armbar kind of thing?
Yeah, I think so too. I don't think you would just jump, you know, jump to your back like that without a strategy. But now she's in a position where Tiburcio can really work that eye, work that, you know, and that's a very, very dangerous thing to do.
She has a 15-second flying armbar victory, does Michelle Waterson. The night Waterson won the Invicta FC crown, top 20 semifinalist Rose Namajunas recorded the fastest finish in Invicta FC history with a 12-second flying armbar. But the key lock here by Tiburcio.
Oh, she has just got that thing leveraged almost all the way around. That's beautiful. Look at Michelle's working. She's staying calm. She's working for that leg, but her shoulder has got to be really, really well. She's out.
Nice reversal by Waterson. Wow.
That was impressive.
I think that cutting to atom weight was a really good move for Tiburcio.
Sometimes the weight cut really affects people, but it does not look like it's affecting her at all. She looks high energy.
Yeah, she looks stronger than she was at strawweight.
Wow. Waterson working from the close guard of Tiburcio. In her corner, getting all kinds of advice. Strategic here for Tiburcio, but she's on the bottom. Eating those strikes from the champion, Michelle Waterson, less than 30 seconds left in the second.
It looks like Tiburcio is trying to hold on so she won't have to take any more damage.
No, but look at the way she's climbing her legs over. I think she's going to try for an armbar right there or sweep. She's using the cage to kind of get that leverage. She's doing a really good job. She's going to come over Michelle's head there.
Wow, she's trying for the armbar, just like Waterson did earlier. Tiburcio looking for the armbar in the dying seconds of the round. Will Waterson be saved by the bell? She is!
Submission versus submission in this fight.
And Waterson looks like she's been in a fight as she struggles to make it to her corner. She was in trouble there in the final seconds of the round.
I think we're going to listen in to some of the corner work going on right here.
But we're actually doing better on the ground. So here's what we're going to do. She's trying to blitz you against the fence, okay? You need some strong center control. A strong straight right hand, a strong right kick to the face. Something in the straight, okay? You hear me? Okay, when it gets in, take it back. When you take it down, get to the mark. Stay on top.
Greg Jackson telling Michelle Waterson to avoid the fence. Try to stay on top, but you could tell in the corner, ladies, that left eye is bothering the champion. And yeah, it should. I mean, look at the mouse that has developed underneath the eye. Swelling, continues to swell shut as this fight progresses.
The half belly shirt is bothering me, sir.
Mm. But of course, we have Stitch Duran, one of the best cut men in the biz, and he'll continue to work on that eye. But yeah, I hear what you're saying, but this is a recording, right? The bell in round number three. Tiburcio, the challenger in the red and gray, the champion Waterson in the blue. Oh, man. Kick, and yet it costs her as Tiburcio capitalizes, but the scramble.
That was a great read of that kick to a treetop takedown.
And Tiburcio is inside control, but look at Waterson now trying to neutralize the head of Tiburcio, and just plenty of action. And now from north-south position, 4:20 left in the third round. Waterson trying to escape. Shrimper hips out and just unbelievable. And now Tiburcio, I thought she was going to transition to an armbar attempt. And now she's going for the guillotine. Arm and guillotine choke attempt by Tiburcio. And Tiburcio has done it! Herica Tiburcio in her Invicta FC debut, in her atomweight debut, has become the Invicta FC champion! Mamma mia! Wow!
Hell of a finish.
And emotions come out from both athletes. An incredible struggle. And for Michelle Waterson, crestfallen, But for Herica Tiburcio,
she's in
amazing and sobbing in the center of the cage, coming into Invicta FC, coming down in weight, and she has just become the Invicta FC 105-pound champion. Both sides of the sport right here on display. The victory and the agony of defeat. What a fight, guys.
That was amazing. The transitions that were happening between the two girls, the way Tiburcio capitalized on that position, you know, just one faulty move any time in this fight, and somebody could have won it. And Herica took the victory. She took the belt.
And how fortuitous was it for Tiburcio, who was supposed to make her Invicta FC debut, at Invicta FC 9, visa issues forcing her out of a planned contender's bout against former Jules lightweight queen champion Ayaka Hamasaki.
And watch the way she does it. She locks in that arm in guillotine, pulls her to the mat, stretches with everything she has, and the champ is forced to tap right on the mat.
Her seventh win via submission, her third via guillotine choke, and it's the biggest win of her career.
I mean, she did such a good job setting that up too. How she really she put her body up high. It wasn't just an arm thing.
It was an incredible amount of commitment to just dive right into that, slam into it. And
Brazil has produced a new champion. Her name is Herica Tiburcio. Let's go and make it official with Joe Martinez.
Ladies and gentlemen, the end comes to the official time. 1:04, round number 3, submission by guillotine for your winner and new Invicta FC atomweight champion of the world, Herica Tiburcio.